community service and civic engagement at Northwestern University. And happy Giving Tuesday, y'all. So tonight we are really excited to have a panel of students, undergraduates, who are very excited to talk about some of their opportunities and experiences they've had at Northwestern. So without further ado, I'm gonna let them introduce themselves. If you have any questions throughout the night, please be sure to drop them in the chat for us and we will answer them as best we can. You'll have an opportunity now to hear each person talk a little bit about some of the organizations they're involved in. My name is Henry. I am a graduate student who works in the Office of Undergraduate Admission. And I was involved at Northwestern in a group called Eye to Eye that is a mentoring organization for students who learn differently, as well as volunteering at Family Focus in Evanston in the Meadow Media Center. So Kayla, would you please introduce yourself?
Yeah, hi everyone. It's so nice to meet you. My name is Kayla and I'm a third year here at Northwestern studying biology and psychology on the pre-med track. And I'm also receiving my minor in business. And when I'm not doing these fun little panels, one of my favorite organizations that I'm a part of at Northwestern is called Mini Chefs. So I'm somebody who personally just really loves cooking and baking, and that's an organization where I really get to explore that. So what we do is we go into downtown Evanston in Chicago and we teach little kids how to cook. But all of the recipes that we use are always healthy, nutritious, and they're also vegetarian, which is really exciting because I'm not vegetarian, but I've definitely gotten to learn a lot through the club. And it's always exciting to get to cook things with little kids and explain to them that, like, hey, like zucchini can be delicious if you like cook it in a way that you like. Can I popcorn over to Maddie?
Awesome. Hi, everyone. I'm Maddie. I'm a senior here at Northwestern. I study human development and psychological services. I have a minor in global health studies on the pre-med track. I keep busy on campus. I am part of an organization called Camp Kesem. We put on a free week of summer camp for children whose parents are affected by cancer. I'm also involved with Northwestern Dance Marathon, which is our big rah-rah Purple Pride event, 30 hours straight of dancing and loads of fun. And we raise money for both Evanston Community Foundation and a local organization. This year, we're benefiting an organization called Compass to Care, so that they provide kind of logistical assistance for families whose children are going through cancer treatments. And also I pop over into the Evanston community itself and I volunteer at the Symphony of Evanston, which is an assisted living facility. So I get to play balloon toss and do watercoloring with individuals who have Alzheimer's and dementia. I will popcorn over to Madelyn.
Hi everyone, my name is Madelyn. I'm a current third year majoring in biology, anthropology, and integrated science with a minor in Chinese. And one organization I'm involved in on campus is called Supplies for Dreams, which is an education nonprofit that offers mentoring and field trips to middle school students in Chicago public schools, of which I am a graduate of. So that's something really close to my heart, as well as I'm in Chinatown Health Initiative, which does translation services for hepatitis B clinics in Chicago's Chinatown. And then I also do STEM outreach through my research lab on campus. And I will pass it to Anamaria.
Hi guys, my name is Ana Maria. I am a senior here at Northwestern in Weinberg, studying cognitive science and history. I've also been able to get involved with a number of different organizations on campus. I was involved with Madelyn and Supplies for Dreams. I have worked and volunteered with the Northwestern Prison Education Program, which basically works with students at Stateville Correctional Center and volunteering, helping tutor and things like that through that program. I've been able to do a lot of different research that partners with community organizations. So super excited to talk to you guys about all of that stuff at Northwestern and what that could look like for you and how you could get involved in all of that. So. Yeah.
Thank you, everybody. Again, feel free to drop your questions in the chat as we go here. But to kick things off, I wanted to weave in one important part of the Northwestern experience is the advising systems we have here for undergraduate students. They aren't just limited to opportunities related to the courses that you're studying or your careers necessarily, because there are so many offices and people willing to connect you with community partnerships. So first, this question is coming to Maddie. Maddie, I know you were a student on the pre-medical track, and I hear that you found a really cool opportunity through pre-health advising. So could you talk a little bit about your experience there?
For sure. So I mentioned that I volunteer at the Symphony of Evanston. So that is an assisted living facility. We're hanging out with people with Alzheimer's and dementia and just trying to brighten their days. And I was actually connected with this opportunity through pre-health advising. I went in, met with my advisor. They're super approachable and just kind of honestly, very enjoyable to work with. And my advisor kind of gave me a list of some very accessible sites where typical kind of pre-health and pre-med students might volunteer, you know, places where it's very easy to sign up and get started right away. And the Symphony of Evanston was absolutely one of those. I think it was literally a 7-minute walk from my house. So very easy to just move from my dorm to being engaged with another community. I think that I will definitely give pre-health credit for helping students, you know, really be confident in choosing opportunities that speak to them. So this, the opportunity that I ended up pursuing was something that I had done in high school and something that I was really missing and longing for on campus. And my pre-health advisor really helped me kind of figure out what was going to be meaningful for me and kind of just enrich my Northwestern experience that much more. And, you know, there are a lot of facets to what pre-health students really need to and feel like they need to and kind of accomplish during their time here. And it really is important to choose those kind of volunteer activities that align with your interests and passions. And advising is super, super useful in that way.
Thank you, Maddie. I know another way that students find out about service organizations and opportunities at Northwestern is just pure word of mouth. So this next question is for Kayla. How easy is it to get involved with a variety of service organizations at Northwestern? What was your experience like coming in as a first-year student?
Yeah, I think that's honestly such a great point. I'm in like so many organizations, and a lot of that reason is because I have friends in these organizations, and they were like, hey, I love this club or activity so much. You should join it. You should come along. And then I try it for that one thing, and I'm like, wow, this is amazing. So that's how I've joined a lot of clubs. And also in terms of like civic engagement, in terms of clubs, a lot of times you're joining one and you might not necessarily know in the beginning, but a lot of our activities are actually also very giving. So an example of this would be club triathlon. So my roommate actually was in club triathlon and she loved it. And she was like, Kayla, you have to come to practice with me. Like you'll enjoy it. And I'm not somebody who really loves like biking or swimming, but I do enjoy running a lot. And so I came in a few practices, everybody was super nice. And every year we have the Krispy Kreme 5K also, which is a 5K that's set up all around campus. And there are like Krispy Kreme donut stands set up along the race as well. And for every donut that you eat, you actually, it shortens the path that you have to run, which seems kind of counterintuitive, but that's how it works. And to enter, you have to pay money. And then all that money we donate at the end of the year as well, which is really exciting. So I would say it might be someone who lives on your floor, your roommate, someone who you meet in your class who's gets you to join an organization. And that's something that you end up wanting to be a part of for a long time, which is how I've ended up joining a lot of my clubs. And I found that people are really open, especially freshman year, to having people come with them to other events because nobody wants to necessarily go by themselves or they want to have a bigger group. And so it's easy to find yourself a part of these things.
Thank you so much, Kayla. So next up, we have a question in the chat from Shreya, and I'm going to quickly turn back to Maddie, I totally misread my notes, y'all. Please pardon that. This question is from Sharon, and I am going to ask Maddie, since I know you're a CESPE student, and I can speak to this as well. As someone who's interested in CESPE, what kind of community organizations are there to engage in civic engagement? And then I'll popcorn off to Anamaria to hear about other community organizations in the Chicagoland area that students can be a part of.
Yeah, for sure. So I would say I'll speak specifically to the practicum, which is one facet of CESPE students' experiences. So basically that is a 4-credit internship that all CESPE students do for 1 quarter. I mention this because Northwestern has these amazing kind of ties and nice relationships with all these different Chicago-based organizations, as well as organizations in San Francisco and DC. So for example, a peer of mine did her practicum experience at a domestic violence advocacy organization. So that is like kind of one example of how that internship experience itself can really have service and advocacy tied up in it. And perhaps Henry could speak to some more organizations through CESPE.
Totally. So the CESPE students who do elect to do the civic engagement certificate do go through a database with their advisor for the program, Nathan, who also advises the overall practicum. And that opportunity is open to students who aren't in the School of Education and Social Policy as well. There are some really interesting elective classes that are part of that experience. I know there was one recently called Saving the Census that you could apply towards the Civic Engagement Certificate. There's a wide variety of programs that are available through the CESPE practicum, as Maddie said, where students typically get involved for their full-time practicum experience. And you can go into that database and look up, for instance, the Children's Cancer Center through Lurie Children's Hospital and what former students have done there volunteering for their full-time practicum. And then maybe you say, hey, I'm gonna look and see if I can find a similar experience for myself, either for your civic engagement certificate or just through word of mouth and taking on some extra time to work in organizations in Chicago. Okay, next up, I think we have a question from earlier that I missed about how clubs have adapted since the start of the pandemic. So Anamaria, would you please kick us off?
Yeah, definitely. I think this is a great, first of all, like a completely understandable question that people are having. Very fair. I would also be wondering kind of how people are managing. And I think people have been, you know, generally really creative about it. And I think at Northwestern's campus, people are really interested in like community and maintaining community. And that's a big aspect of, you know, why we're all involved in all of these different things is obviously we care about the work that we're doing, but it's also a matter of, you know, wanting to be connected with each other, wanting to be connected with people who, you know, enjoy this kind of similar work. And so I think my experience has really been, you know, for certain things, it's not necessarily going to look like what it was, especially for a lot of these more like community engagement oriented type of clubs and things like that. But I think people have been really working to still stay connected and to, you know, at least like socialize distantly or virtually or whatever that might be, or just, you know, continue engaging in what ways they can. So, you know, for example, like one aspect of kind of like a different type of community engagement that I do is helping with this podcast, Nine Lives, which is covering Northwestern stories. And so we've kind of shifted to, you know, covering stories virtually or just at least checking in with each other, staying connected in different ways. So there's definitely still opportunities to engage. And also, you know, people are redirecting resources or redirecting energy to make sure to be able to continue to do that.
Thanks, Anamaria. Kayla, did you have any additional thoughts to add about how your organizations have been operating lately and what you've learned in this time when there's a lot of virtual work going on?
Yeah, definitely. So like Anamaria was saying, like being online has definitely brought some challenges. It can be a little bit harder to socialize, but we do still have events over Zoom. Like we've had like a few game nights or like Netflix watch parties and stuff that still keep members in connection with each other. But also the fact that we're online has given us some really unique opportunities to explore other things as well. So for example, every year our Black Student Union on campus has a State of the Black Union address. And this year we were able to get Angela Davis as a speaker, which may or may not have happened if everything was like still in person. So it was really cool that we got to have such an amazing and inspiring woman come and talk to us and share her ideas with us. Additionally, we've had a lot more in some of my like pre-medical clubs, we've been able to have a lot more interactions like FaceTimes or Zooms with current medical students or even the Dean of Feinberg, which is Northwestern's medical campus. So it's been really exciting just the amount of people that we've actually been able to meet, even if it's virtually, but I feel like that's been a really unique opportunity specifically because we are online right now.
Thanks, Kayla. So on that note about the number of people you meet in the organizations that you're involved in on campus and, you know, what motivates you to get involved, this question's coming to Madelyn, and it is from Sharon. Are there classes at Northwestern that kind of revolve around a community service project, or is this something that getting involved in service, something that Northwestern students just do on their own?
I think there's a good mixture of both. There's definitely structured opportunities in your classes if that's something you're interested in, but as well as if you want to go out on your own, whether that's through student organizations or things like the Center for Civic Engagement on campus, there's tons of opportunities for students to do that as well. I personally have not had the experience of in a specific class visiting, but I've heard of other students, such as do the prison education initiative that Anamaria mentioned, that they get to go with their professors and go to a local prison near us and help teach inmates about certain topics that they're learning about. And then in my own experience, I found a lot through the student organization fairs that was previously mentioned about. And that's how I found about Supplies for Dreams. I think also too, just like hearing from friends, like I heard about other clubs, for example, with my interest in my Chinese minor about translation and how I could possibly use my skills there to help people in the community. And so I think there's lots of different ways for students to find things. Maddie, you might know a little bit more just because you're in SESB about specific opportunities in classes, but that's been my experience.
Yes, I too have mostly had classes that have been kind of separate from service opportunities, but I have had a number of professors introduce us to the type of work that they're involved in the community. And it's nice to kind of get that experience from your professor as well, thinking, you know, here are these professional people who are still involved in service and have civic engagements. And for example, one of my professors took us to, similar to the type of volunteering I do, to an assisted living facility. And it was really nice to just spend our class period just interacting and hanging out and doing a lot of learning. And I guess you could kind of count that as service too, because I think there's definitely some kind of impact of having a visit there. But yes, that is my experience with that.
Totally. And I think that ties into Maham's question about whether applying to the College of Arts and Sciences, would you still have, you know, practicum opportunities or opportunities to do a long-term project and really have it be the focus? Yes, the answer is yes. It may just look a little different on your transcript. We do have programs available through the Chicago Field Studies Office. There are summer programs and fellowships you can apply to join. Engage Chicago is a really popular one. And it really is not going to limit you, you know, from community service opportunities at Northwestern just because you're applying to one of the six schools. You know, there are different opportunities everywhere. I think I just mentioned SESB specifically because I know it's such a focal point of the curriculum for us. Even in small classes, kind of like Maddie was saying, I know I had a class called Schooling in Communities where I kind of stumbled into working at Family Focus that way because they were interested in having people come work in their metamedia center, which came about really cool because of community feedback in Evanston that there was a lot of programming going on for high schoolers and elementary schoolers, but the middle schoolers had nothing to do. So that's their space where they can go after school and tinker around with technology and make really cool 3D printing designs, video projects, recording studios, things like that. All right. So the next question I want to address, we've had a few people interested in dance marathon at Northwestern. So I'm going to flip back to Maddie. Could you talk a little bit about your experience specifically with that fabulous tradition?
For sure. So first, I think it's useful to kind of have a visual of what this looks like. So picture a giant bubble filled with amazing, spirited, dancing students, lights flashing, like a constant 30-hour concert. And that's kind of like the big event. Of course, this year it might be a bit reimagined, but really there's a lot of brilliant minds from a lot of different disciplines on campus coming together to make this work. So students can really pick what interests them, what they want to contribute to this event. So for example, I consider myself more on the spirited end and more concerned with the accessibility of the event. So thinking about kind of what kind of accommodations might students need if they want to stay and participate in this long dance marathon. Also, what kind of accommodations might students need in terms of financial barriers to fundraising? Also, just coming up with creative ways for people to fundraise. So I joined the Dancer Accessibility and Experience Committee. We're also famous for our foot massages, which we give midway through dance marathon. I imagine that sounds kind of icky, but once you start to understand kind of this cohesive purple pride that we have and how that all comes out in this big tent, I think that makes a lot more sense there. So the event really, there's the big kind of event, but there's a lot of planning and fundraising that goes in before then. Also students with all different skills, like I mentioned. So for example, a close friend of mine is interested in film, and she's really taken this opportunity to volunteer with Dance Marathon and use her videography skills and really practice them and end up kind of filming parts of the event, which of course is like another huge part of it. And so really it's just a nice opportunity for students to bring all of their energy. I would say that is kind of uniform across all Northwestern students, and really anyone who wants to participate in this event can. So that's the exciting part there, and can bring whatever skills they have to the table and find ways to contribute. And to me, that's what makes the event so special.
Thank you, Maddie. And we did have another question from earlier from Joshua, and this is coming to Madelyn. Could the student who mentioned STEM outreach elaborate more on what specific activities they were able to do?
Yeah, sure. So I work in a biological anthropology lab on campus where we study the gut microbiome, so a bunch of different microbes that live in your gut. And part of our research includes outreach to local school children in the Chicago, Evanston area. So we recently did an event with SPLASH, which is a student organization on campus that has these kind of little seminars for high school students to attend. And so we recently did one on the microbiome and probiotics and prebiotics. And it's been making a lot of news lately about how this might be beneficial for health. And so we had a discussion on that. We also work with other organizations in the Chicago area, nonprofits, as well as partnering with some schools. We have a school in Oak Park that we work with where we teach them about different things. And we've also made a video. So lots of different ways to get involved. And I think this is something that a lot of research labs on campus are interested in doing, is not only doing good research, but making sure that's accessible and communicable to people in the community. And so that's been a lot of fun.
Thank you. All right. Let's see. Thank you all for asking such great questions in the chat. We're going to try to get to as many as we can. Next up, let's go to Kayla. This is coming from Emily. I was wondering if many students struggle with the number of activities offered, as the academic curriculum probably doesn't allow them to join a lot of them simultaneously. Thank you for answering.
Yeah, I think that's a great question. And that's a question that I get a lot, because if I like provided you with a list of things I wouldn't be involved in, that's of course the first thing you would ask. I'm someone who really likes to get involved and like do things myself and like be active. So that like results in me being involved in a lot of things and having a lot of responsibilities. And also when you compile that with a class, with your class load at Northwestern, as well as being pre-med, which can also be difficult, I think it's really a matter of truly just using a Google Calendar. Like if you are someone who's able to manage your time well and like plan out when you're gonna spend time with friends, when you're going to do your homework, and when you're gonna have time for these other activities that you're passionate about, it really gets that much easier. I also think a big thing is to actually enjoy the things that you are a part of. So if you're involving yourself in activities that you truly want to give time to, it won't feel as much like a chore or responsibility to do so. Additionally, Northwestern, we have something like over 500 student organizations here on campus. So it should be easy and to find an organization that you're passionate about. And if you can't, you can also always start one, which is super easy. So to answer your question, Emily, I would say that as long as you have good time management skills and you're excited about what you're working on, it should be no problem at all for you to balance your time.
Thanks, Kayla. All right, our next question is zooming out a little more to some of the international civic engagement opportunities at Northwestern. So Anamaria, I know you were involved with GESI, so would you mind sharing your experience with that program?
Yeah, definitely. So summer after my freshman year, I was able to be involved in the GESI program, which is basically a program that is kind of like a study abroad mixed with civic engagement type of program. So you basically apply to a host of different countries where the program runs, and you go there, you live with a host family, you work with NGOs, and basically do kind of through guidance of professors and supervisors and things, community development projects. And so I really got to have this experience of doing kind of some of this work that I've been doing at home, of, you know, being engaged in my community, doing some of this work and applying it somewhere else. So you really kind of get to, you know, be a part of the community, get to know people, and then work with them and kind of learn through them, you know, different types of community development work and strategy and all that kind of stuff that's applicable both at home or abroad, if that's something you choose to do later on.
Thanks, Anamaria. All right, we've got a few similar questions here that I'm piecing through, and I want to make sure I get all of them. But first, just regarding the general activism culture in terms of civic engagement and other programs at Northwestern, Madelyn, could you speak a little bit about just the general activist culture? This is for Abigail's question.
Yes, I can. So I would say activism at Northwestern is very much supported, whether or not you want to be a part of those groups. And depending on how involved you want to be, there's a number of different organizations you can join. Some of the top ones that come to my head is I've seen protests about, I think it's Fossil Free NU, which is talking about divesting Northwestern's endowment from fossil fuels. There's NU Community Not Cops, which is talking about the Northwestern's relationship with police. There's lots of different organizations on campus that students can be a part of. And a lot of times there's a lot of engagement through social media. There's sometimes protests on campus. These groups all hold meetings. So if you wanna join these groups, you can. You also can just be supporters. I've seen protests where people start protesting and then just other peers just join in, whether or not they're part of that organization. And so I definitely think that at Northwestern, the activism culture, if you want to be a part of that, it's definitely there and you can join.
Thank you, Madelyn. Okay. About the curriculum and, just benefits to kind of prioritizing opportunities that are related to your major or not. We have a question from Austin that I would love to pitch to Maddie. Are there any major benefits to prioritize a service opportunity related to your major, or on the other side, downsides to taking up service opportunities not related to it?
I love this question because I think that this really brings up time management and really figuring out where you want to focus your energies kind of in a fast-paced, vibrant college community. Personally, I've derived a lot of joy, and I think that my volunteering has really kind of helped me solidify my career interests. So there's definitely a benefit there. I also think that some of the other panelists touched on the social benefits. These are really amazing opportunities to connect with students from all across campus. And I think that people come to these organizations excited and passionate. And I don't know that I can really put a value on that versus, you know, focus on coursework. I think that each person really needs to come join activities that are meaningful to them and really either fit with what you want to do or really allow you to just explore something that's totally outside of what you do. So, I mean, so sometimes I'll hang out and with some various cooking clubs that are based in Hillel. They bake challah each week. I am terrible in the kitchen, can't bake for myself, but really, really enjoy getting to hang out. And I always donate and get some of those challahs myself. So I think that using clubs, using services to really just help your personal development. I think when you come to college, you're not just coming for the academic experience. You're coming for those kind of out of the classroom learning experiences as well. And those really can, one, be to help your professional goals, and two, have social and personal benefits as well.
Thanks, Maddie. We'll have to learn together how to bake better. All right, next question for Kayla. This is coming to you from Ronnie and from Grant too. How supportive and engaged is the student body in social justice issues? How much of a voice do they have on campus? And what organizations are available for people interested in political activism?
Yeah, I think this is a really great question, especially like given the current state of America and kind of the world right now. Like there's been a lot of different political tensions, like lots of things are coming up, new ideas, or not necessarily new, but new to other people in the Northwestern community, and campus has definitely responded to that. So there are always some clubs that you can join that are like politically involved, such as our political union, which holds like different debates sometimes and just also has different
discussions between students. We also have a college Democrats and a college Republicans who are sometimes responsible for speakers coming to campus. They also hold discussions between students as well. But you can really see Northwestern students like activating themselves. And so whenever students feel passionate about an issue, you'll see people start constructing petitions that need to be signed or writing letters to administration or to our different representatives within Chicago and Illinois. So it's been really exciting and really great for me to see and participate in student activism on campus. Also, the ROC is something that you might have heard of. And so that's on campus. That's a way for students to also express their freedom of speech. So any student can kind of camp out in front of the ROC for 24 hours and then they get to paint it with whatever they want. So that is one way that students like express how they might be feeling about campus or about the world. But I would say our students have done a really good job. And a lot of times our faculty has even backed them sometimes. So if you see students writing a petition or organizing in some way, sometimes different departments like our political science department, our African American studies department, our psych department will come out in support of those students as well and show that the administration is really on the sides of the students.
Thank you, Kayla. All right, next up, we have a question about affinity groups on campus. This is going to Madelyn. I know we heard from Maddie already about Hillel. Do affinity groups on campus engage in community service and engagement?
Yeah, so in terms of different affinity groups, there's definitely ways to contribute back to your community. So I mentioned earlier, I'm in Chinatown Health Initiative, where we have a lot of people who ethnically identify as Chinese. And so we go into the Chinatown community in Chicago and we do different translation services, as well as also trying to make sure that we do culturally aware things. And there might be differences between Eastern and Western medicine and things like that, which is a really cool way that I can use my identity to give back. There's other organizations on campus. I know the Catholic Center sometimes does volunteering events. And it all kind of just depends on where you find your space on campus. I also know too that if you're interested in starting a volunteering opportunity, that's definitely something you can do. If you identify in a certain space and you want to go help a certain community in the Chicago area or maybe in the Evanston community, that's definitely an option for you to do as well.
Thanks, Madelyn. And I know I was actually wondering really quickly for a follow-up question about one of the organizations someone had mentioned is Splash at Northwestern. So Sean would like to know, can students in Splash teach and create a curriculum for any topic they are passionate about?
Yeah, so Splash has been really great in my experience working with them of really letting you build your own curriculum from the ground up and trying to figure out what exactly you want to do. It really comes at it from the perspective of if you're in the school, in the shoes of a high school student, what might you be interested in? And so just this past, I think, month or so, we actually had a virtual Splash event. I mentioned earlier, talked about the gut microbiome. We had this really cool scavenger hunt where we had people run around their houses and try to bring back as many items as they thought that might have microbes in them. So like yogurts, or things like that, like kimchi we had someone bring in. So there's lots of really cool ways that you can do it. And typically while it's in person, there's been a lot of really creative online curriculums that people have been able to come up with. And so that's definitely been something really fun to be a part of.
Thanks, Madelyn. All right, this next question, I know we have a couple of students who are on the pre-medical track, including Madelyn, but I'll give you a break since you just answered so many. So first to Maddie and then to Kayla, could you speak a little bit about opportunities to volunteer in hospitals and similar organizations?
For sure. So we are blessed to have hospitals right within walking distance of campus, and they definitely accept volunteers. You just kind of have to pay attention to like when they're recruiting volunteers, and it's very easy to you get your TB test and you get cleared and go on over and you can really volunteer there. A friend of mine, I think she volunteered in the emergency department, just kind of walking around and checking in on patients. Another friend of mine volunteers at Lurie Children's Hospital downtown. She really enjoys her commute downtown and just the opportunity to work with, I believe she works with children who do have cancer currently. And she'll read stories with them, just hang out. And she's built some really high quality relationships through that. And she was also connected with that opportunity through pre-health advising. But as Henry said earlier, these opportunities circulate through word of mouth as well. And they're really not too hard to get involved with. It's more about just figuring out where you want to be, what you want to be doing, and what you have time for.
Yeah, I can also add on to that too. So Free Health Advising, they circulate a listserv every week, which is really helpful. There's always a ton of opportunities listed there, whether you're looking for a pre-med mentor, a med school advisor, or just different activities that are in and around the Evanston and Chicago community, some things that are Northwestern related and some things that aren't. If there's anything at all where you can get involved with like volunteering and getting clinical experience, they will definitely put that in the listserv. Also, there's something really cool that we have that is in part because we have Northwestern's Feinberg connected to us. There's a program that you have to apply for, but once you get into it, you get to go to Feinberg for 5 hours every Friday, every other week for the whole entire quarter and participate in different shadowing and volunteering opportunities in the hospital. And so that's a great way to do some volunteering within a hospital environment. I also am a part of a research that is through Feinberg as well. And so that one is with women who have metastatic breast cancer. And so we're really looking into finding ways that exercise and health can help benefit their prognosis.
Thank you, Kayla and Maddie, certainly making impacts in the medical hospital sectors of Evanston and Chicago. I wanted to also ask Anamaria a question from Shreya. What is the most memorable or impactful experience you have had while doing community service at Northwestern and in the Evanston, Chicago area?
That's a great question. I think my different experiences have been pretty unique and pretty memorable in different ways. I think I briefly touched on this before, but being able to volunteer with the Northwestern Prison Education Program is one of the most memorable experiences, if not of Northwestern, than of my life more broadly. I think it's, you know, one of those things where truly the experience is really life-changing. And I think being able to, you know, engage with people outside of the campus community in a very different space is a huge part of that. And then also being able to do that with grad students and professors from Northwestern who, you know, you spend a lot of time with, you get really close with, you're doing this work with. I think both aspects of that make it really special and really unique. And you just get to form some really, really valuable and meaningful relationships. And I think for me, that's a huge part of what civic engagement is and what it looks like, is really connecting with people. And then I was able to do that in a really real way with that.
Thanks, Anamaria. And I'm going to go ahead and let Madelyn answer that same question as well, since there are so many different answers you could give.
Yeah, I think one that was really fun for me was through Supplies for Dreams. I helped chaperone a field trip of sixth graders to the Chicago History Museum. And I don't know if anyone has ever been, but they have this one particular exhibit where you can be a Chicago hot dog. So it's basically this bed that's the bun, and then you can add all these like different toppings, and the student is the hot dog. And I think that was really fun to watch with the students, and that it's really cool to have this kind of like hands-on exhibit. But it's just also really fun for people to figure out like different cuisines that are native to Chicago. So everyone hears about like the deep dish pizza, and then there's like a hot dog, and then there's the beef steaks and all that. And so I think that was just really fun. And for students who are from Chicago, but might not necessarily like know about all of Chicago's history, I think this is just a really cool hands-on way. And it was really fun to watch the students kind of run around and have fun with all the different toppings that they could put on their classmates.
Totally. I mean, some of the most, you know, meaningful experiences I've had kind of in happenstance. I remember there was one afternoon where my friend Jack kind of said, hey, please turn up tomorrow to see me shave my head for St. Baldrick's, because a child gets diagnosed with cancer about every 2 minutes. And I thought to myself, oh my gosh, is it too late to help get involved? And so I kind of just signed up on a whim. I never had my hair cut shorter than it is now, but I was like, this sounds so exciting, and I'd love to raise money for children's cancer research. So I just went down and shaved my head. My mom was shocked, but I don't know. It was kind of at a point midway through Northwestern where I was like, I need to do more and be more involved. So if an opportunity comes up, I'm just going to take advantage of it and put aside my agenda for the day and do it. And I wouldn't say that that's uncommon at Northwestern. A lot of times you kind of stumble into opportunities that are really meaningful. Just on a regular basis. All right. So another question that we have, and I'm going to let a couple of our counselors answer just as we're sort of wrapping up here, is why specifically did you choose Northwestern? What stood out to you as the most impactful thing? Anything about service opportunities that stood out to you that you were really interested in being a part of once you got to Northwestern? And we will start with Anamaria.
Yeah, I think for me, one thing that I always touch on that I think is really true, and I think being on a panel like this, it's a lot easier for you to see it as opposed to me telling you. But I think for me, something I really cared about was having this community of people who was really passionate about, you know, about different subjects or things or being engaged with the community or whatever it might be. And it wasn't necessarily that they all had to share the same passions as me, but just that they had them. And I think that is like a really palpable thing at Northwestern. You can see it here with the students we're talking to now. You can see it, I think, at most points. And I think, you know, no matter what it is that you're excited about, everyone else is excited about something just as much too. They're excited for you that you're excited. They're excited about whatever it is they're doing. And I think that's an energy that I really, really appreciated having in a college experience because, you know, it gets me more amped about what I'm doing and people really care. And that's really, really meaningful to have that around campus.
Thank you, Anamaria. So, and thank you to everyone else who was able to tune in for today's session. Be sure to check out the upcoming events we have on our admissions webpage about YouTube panels like this one. And the regular decision deadline is coming up to apply. So be sure to jot that down if you are looking to apply to Northwestern. But thank you to our panelists, Maddie, Kayla, Madelyn, Anamaria. If you have any additional questions that you didn't get answered tonight that may or may not be about service and volunteer opportunities, please reach out to us at ug-admission@northwestern.edu, and we'd be happy to connect you with one of our counselors. Anyway, we hope you have a great week, and we hope to see you at a future event. Stay safe and go Cats!